Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Taylor Manalili, and today we are going to discuss how I like to utilize monolithic zirconia when I'm restoring my full arch implant restorations. So once they're all situated in the mouth and you have a little space between each one, you're going to then go ahead and connect them. You're going to connect the segments using either a flowable composite is probably the easiest. You can also use a salt and pepper acrylic if you wish. So something to connect those segments together. You want to make sure they're connected all the way under and completely through. So sometimes once they're connected, I'll let it set and then I unscrew the prosthesis, look underneath, make sure it's a solid one piece. Okay, so once that's all set, you're going to then take your custom tray that the lab is giving you. So this is lab provided. It fits directly over the implant verification jig that they gave you. Now we've kind of told the lab what we like and don't like of our initial try-in. So before we send this back, we have to take a bite registration. This is where a lot of people struggle. And one of the reasons I like to eliminate the posterior teeth is because a lot of times when we're taking bite registrations on people that have either been a dentulous or partially a dentulous, their bites are off, right? So they're not 100% familiar with where or comfortable with where they bite. So once we're happy with our occlusal scheme, we can send that back to the lab and they are going to send us back a provisional restoration. This is a very important part of the process that allows us to test drive our prosthesis before getting to that final. So it's either gonna be made out of or printed out of a microfilled hybrid resin or milled out of polymethyl methacrylate puck. Another thing I like to do at this phase is review home care. So I like to go through, either myself or my assistant will go through, make sure you're able to floss in between each implant and under the prosthesis. If you cannot do it as the dentist, there is no way your patient is gonna be able to get in there. So once it's seated, you're gonna go ahead. I like to, when I do this, I think of it as kind of like a tire. Whenever I'm placing a new tire on, how I screw in the lug nuts, similar fashion. So you go from one side to the opposite side to the furthest away again and so on. I hand tighten them all once and then I'm going to go ahead with my torque wrench and then go through and torque them into place. Again, these are multi-unit prosthetic screws, so they're going to be torqued down to only 15 Newton centimeters. This is how I like to insert this Teflon tape. So I roll it up into little tubes and then I'm able to push it in with a composite plugger. Once they're all in the channels, then I'm going to leave about 3-4 millimeters of space for composite. And then you fill it up and you can then check and adjust your occlusion as so. So once the prosthesis is in, again, I'm using those 2 Miller forceps to check my bite, check the occlusion, and then I'm going to go ahead. I start with those diamond burrs for any gross adjustments and finish up with those dialyte burrs to ensure that nice, smooth, polished finish. A high polish on all of your zirconia restorations is highly recommended because it definitely limits the wear of the opposing dentition. So if it's highly polished, it's actually one of the best things for natural enamel as far as dental prostheses go. So thank you for joining me today as we discussed how to utilize monolithic zirconia. Hope you will take into consideration why we're utilizing zirconia, any pre-surgical considerations that we discussed, as well as now understanding the full arch protocol when utilizing this material. So thank you again for joining us and keep smiling.
Are you enjoying this instructional video? I hope so. If you'd like to receive additional clinical instruction with AGD and ADA approved CE credits, all at no charge, be sure to visit glidewelldental.com/education, where in addition to over 60 on-demand clinical courses, you can also access our weekly webinars along with other valuable content.